subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. This is one of the most requested video from you students. Ma'am, please tell us what are the expected questions, what is the important weightage chapter wise and subject wise, and what will be the difficulty level of the paper. So this is most requested video. So guys, I'm also going to tell the same in Telugu, so don't worry. Guys, ee video anedi chaala chaala mandi request chesaru cheyamani. Ma'am, ee questions vastayi exam lo, ee topic nunchi enni questions vache chances unnai, and gunshot questions enti, elanti questions vastayi exam lo, ee video cheyandi madam please ani chaala mandi request chesaru. So final ga nenu chestunnanu, anduke ee video last varaku watch cheyandi, okay na? So yes, now let's begin this video without any delay. First let's see what is the expected number of questions for from mathematics. Okay, so first let's see what are the expected number of questions for mathematics. Okay guys, remember one thing, I am going to tell the same in Telugu also, so don't worry Telugu students. Okay, so guys, first listen to me carefully. Let's first see what is the weightage of mathematics for first year and second intermediate. Okay, so from first year, 40% of the questions will be asked. Okay, from intermediate first year syllabus in MCET exam paper, you are going to get 40% of the questions. Okay, so from the second year of intermediate syllabus, you are going to get 40% of the questions. So totally 40% of the weightage from intermediate first year mathematics syllabus, and 40% of the And BIPC students, don't go away, because in this video I'm also going to cover the subjects of biology, physics and chemistry also, so don't worry. Okay, so from second year intermediate weightage, you're going to get 40% of the questions. Okay, so totally 80% of the questions. Then what about rest 20% of the questions? 20% of the questions will be in the examiner hand. Okay, they can put the 20% of the questions from either first year's topics or second year's topics. It's absolutely their choice. So guys, I'm not going to tell the same in Telugu. Students, MPC students, careful ga vinandi. BIPC స్టూడెంట్స్ వరి అవనవసరం లేదు, బికాస్ మీకు ఇదే వీడియోలో నేను బయాలజీ కెమిస్ట్రీ ఫిజిక్స్ కూడా కవర్ చేస్తాను, సో వాచ్ చేయండి వీడియోని. సో గైస్, మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ స్టూడెంట్స్ లిజన్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ, మనకి ఇంటర్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ సిలబస్లోంచి ఎంసెట్ క్వశ్చన్ పేపర్లో 40% ఆఫ్ ద క్వశ్చన్స్ వస్తాయి. ఇంటర్ సెకండ్ ఇయర్ ఇంటర్మీడియట్ సెకండ్ ఇయర్ సిలబస్లో 40% ఆఫ్ ద క్వశ్చన్స్ కవర్ అవుతాయి. అండ్ ఈ రెండు కలిపి ఎంత, ఇంటర్ ఫస్ట్ ఇంటర్మీడియట్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ 40% వెయిటేజ్, ఇంటర్మీడియట్ సెకండ్ ఇయర్ 40% వెయిటేజ్ కదా, ఈ రెండు కలిపితే 80% అవుతున్నాయి మేడం, మరి మిగిలిన 20% ఏంటి అని మీకు డౌట్ రావచ్చు కదా. ఏమీ లేదు, ఆ 20% అనేది పేపర్ సెట్ చేసే వాళ్ళ ఇష్టము. ఆ 20% ఆఫ్ ద క్వశ్చన్స్ వాళ్ళు ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ నుంచి అన్నా అడగచ్చు, సెకండ్ ఇయర్ నుంచి అన్నా అడగచ్చు, కానీ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ సిలబస్ అయితే రాదు. సో ఏం టెన్షన్ పడిన అవసరం లేదు, ఓకేనా? సో ఇప్పుడు మనం వచ్చేసి డిఫికల్టీ లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎగ్జామ్ పేపర్ చూద్దాం. సో గైస్, నౌ లెట్స్ సీ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫికల్టీ లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎగ్జామ్ పేపర్. ఓకే సో గైస్, కమింగ్ టు ద మ్యాథమెటిక్స్. ఓకే సో కమింగ్ టు ద మ్యాథమెటిక్స్, 51 క్వశ్చన్స్, ఓకే అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 80, 51 క్వశ్చన్స్ you will be having easy questions, okay, out of the entire MCET paper. Coming to mathematics, there will be 80 questions, and out of 80 questions, good news for you people is 50 to 51 questions will be easy, okay, they will be very easy, and 18 questions will be average level, like the moderate difficult. You if you work hard, you will be able to solve them, and 8 questions will be very hard. Okay, so don't worry, 8 questions also, if you give a bit more extra time, you will be able to solve. And guys, coming to mathematics, you should be really really good with the formulae, don't forget that. So my Telugu students, ఎంసెట్ పేపర్లో మనకి 80 క్వశ్చన్స్ అడుగుతారు కదా మ్యాథ్స్ నుంచి, ఆ 80 క్వశ్చన్స్లో 51 అంటే 51 క్వశ్చన్స్ చాలా చాలా ఈజీ క్వశ్చన్స్ అడుగుతారు. 18 క్వశ్చన్లు ఏమో మోడరేట్ లెవెల్ అంటే ఎక్కువ సులభంగా ఉండవు ఎక్కువ కష్టంగా ఉండవు అలాంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ అడుగుతారు 18. అండ్ మిగిలిన 8 వచ్చేసి కొంచెం కష్టం క్వశ్చన్ కష్టమైన క్వశ్చన్స్ అడుగుతారు. ఇవి కూడా మీకు ఫార్ములా తెలిసి కొంచెం ఎక్కువ టైం కేటాయిస్తే మీరు తప్పకుండా ఈ డిఫికల్ట్ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేది కూడా సాల్వ్ చేయొచ్చు. So guys, now let's see from which topics difficult questions will come, easy questions will come and moderate level questions will come. Okay, from calculus. Okay, from calculus, guys, remember one thing, this is the common video for both TS MCET and AP MCET. So also do check your syllabus. Okay, so I'm not making this video separately for either AP or TS. It is for both, so make sure you even check with your updated syllabus. Okay, so yes, coming to the calculus, guys, coming to the calculus, 11 easy questions will be asked, 4 average questions, like you know, a moderate level questions will be asked, and 4 difficult questions will be asked. Okay, so totally 19 questions will be asked from the calculus. Okay, so coming to the trigonometry, 9 easy questions will be asked, 3 average questions will be asked, 1 difficult question will be asked. Coming to the algebra, so coming to the trigonometry, totally you're going to have 13 questions in your paper. Okay, so coming to the algebra, 9 easy questions will be asked, 5 average questions will be asked, 1 difficult questions will be asked. So from algebra, totally you're going to get 15 questions. Okay, so coming to the probability, 3 questions will be asked from the probability, like 3 easy questions will be asked. Okay, so 2 average questions will be asked from probability and 2 difficult questions will be asked. Okay, so totally from probability 7 questions are going to appear in your exam paper. Okay, so from vector algebra, 4 easy questions will be asked, 1 average question will be asked, 1 difficult question will be asked. So totally from vector algebra, you're going to get 6 questions, okay, in your MCET exam. So last but not least, which is having one of the highest weightage in the entire paper, coordinate geometry. So coming through this coordinate geometry, 15 questions will be asked, which will be very easy. Okay, 15 easy questions will be asked. 3 average questions will be asked, 2 difficult questions will be asked. Okay, so totally from coordinate geometry, 20 questions are going to be appeared in your exam. Okay, so guys, I'm going to tell you a tip for the students who wanted to get complete marks. Okay, so guys, as I already told you, coming to the mathematics, easy questions 51, average difficult level questions 18, and hard questions 8, right? So the students who wanted to get below rank 1000, give the first priority to these difficult 8 questions. Okay, guys, as I have already told you, in MCET, even 1 mark will bring a lot of change in your rank. That's why always never ever ignore the difficult level questions, because this is only the difference between other students and you. Okay, they will ignore difficult questions, but the students who want to get rank below 1000, they should never ignore difficult level questions. Okay, then to the physics first year, 4 questions will be asked from laws of motion. Okay, so guys, from the laws of motion, mostly they like you have to give equal preference for laws of motion, because from laws of motion mostly they'll be asking you easy questions only, so need not worry, but give this high priority, because from this particular topic 4 questions are going to be asked. Okay, and from motion in a straight line, 2 questions will be asked. From motion in a plane, 2 questions will be asked. From thermal properties of matter, 2 questions. From thermodynamics, 2 questions. From rest of all the topics from first year, only one question. Okay, so coming to the second year, coming to the ray optics, 2 questions. Wave optics, 2 questions. Current electricity, 2 questions. Moving charges and magnetism, 2 questions. and semiconductor electronics, two questions. Okay, so from second year, these are the topics where two questions will be asked. From rest all the topics, just one question will be asked. So now let's see year wise weightage. Okay, so coming to the physics, from intermediate first year syllabus, out of 40 questions, 21 questions will be asked from intermediate first year syllabus. Okay, so and from second year intermediate syllabus, 19 questions will be asked. Okay, so now you understood, right? So intermediate first year syllabus is given more priority compared to the second year syllabus, so give a bit more concentration to the first year syllabus. Okay, so yes, now let's see. So now let's see the chemistry. Okay, so coming to the chemistry, from organic organic chemistry, 8 questions will be asked. From physical chemistry, 15 questions will be asked. From inorganic chemistry, 13 questions will be asked. From rest all topics, 4 questions will be asked. Okay, so guys, coming to the now let's see what kind of questions will be asked from botany as well as zoology. Okay, so guys, coming to the botany, 2 questions will be asked in the form of assertion and reasoning. They will give you assertion and you have to find out the reason for it. Okay, so next is 10 questions will be asked in the form of match the following in the botany. Okay, so guys, concentrate on match the following, because in botany especially 10 questions will be asked only for in the form of match the following. Okay, so next to MCQs, multiple choice questions. So 8 questions will be asked in the form of multiple choice questions. Okay, so from assertion and reasoning, 2 kind of questions, match the following, 10 kind of questions, and from multiple choice questions, 8 form of questions, coming to the botany. Okay, so coming to the zoology, you have to there are 2 topics which are like utmost prioritized topics. First one is human anatomy and physiology. 11 questions are expected from human anatomy and physiology. And coming to the second important topic, genetics, from genetics, 6 questions will be asked in the exam. Okay, so yes, now let's see what is the so guys, now let's see what, like, you know, especially for the students who have target below 2000, to get below 2000 rank, now it's just for you. Listen carefully, guys. Out of 80 marks in mathematics, if you get 80 on 80, it is the best score. So the students who have target as you know, the rank below 1000 or 500, so your score target should be 80 for mathematics. And average, like if any students want to get rank below 5000 or 10000, you can get marks below 5. Okay, so the students who have target to get rank below 1000, you have to put mathematics target as 80, and other students can get marks around 55. Okay, so coming to physics, okay, so students, if you get 38 or 37, it's the best score and you're going to get good rank. And other students, it's better if you get above 15 marks in physics. Okay, so coming to the chemistry, if like the best target of the topper students should be 38. Okay, other students, you have to get at least above 20 or 20 25 or like that. Okay, around 25. Okay, so now coming to the botany, the topper students, you have to put your target as 38. Other students who have a less target, they can put the their target as 25. Okay, so coming to the zoology, the target should be 38 or 39. It is important to get good marks in zoology. And other students, you can put the target around 35. Okay, so yes, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Okay, the more likes, the more videos I'm going to do. So yes, that's it for today. And yes, please make your preparation a bit seriously because you have very less time for your exam, and every moment is precious from today. So yes, thanks for watching, and please subscribe, like, and share.